I heard about a year ago that this little girl got bullied at BLFC. This hurt me because the furry fandom is supposed to be accepting, not bully others over quality of their suit. It makes no sense to me. But since she got bullied so badly at her first con, I decided to make her a gift. When I heard about those mean mice, my heart sank. Because we are supposed to support each other, not tear each other down. And I've decided to show my support towards Emma being a furry by making her a lovely suit. I decided to make her this suit because, honestly, she deserves it. If somebody's gonna pick on her for not being able to afford a fursuit at, like, her age, that's stupid. This is to make up for her bad experience at the con. As a furry, I want to show her that the fandom is not bad. Unlike those mice. My message to Emma is that I really hope you enjoy your suit. I tried so hard on it. Her stripes were really, really hard, because I'm not really a pro yet, but I was really happy to do it for you. And I really hope you like it. My gift came with this head, paws, cute little Emma paws, and her beautiful tail. This was also very, very hard, and the stripes aren't exactly perfect. But I followed the ref as best as I could. So, hope you like it. I have a message for all you furries that think you're better than people just because of your suit quality. Stop. Just stop. That's like rich people thinking they're better than everybody else because they have money. It's material. Literally, material objects don't make you better than anyone. Your morals do. And when you do stuff like that at cons, it really shows what type of person you are. So be sure to treat everyone the way you want to be treated, because it's not cute to do that. You're not better. You're actually morally worse than the person you're making fun of. Bullying just is not okay. Ever. Furries, school, work. Bullying is harassment. Don't do it. You'll find yourself having a lot of bad karma and probably getting banned from whatever con you're at. Just don't bully people. I saw that some really kind furs set up a GoFundMe for Emma's fursuit, and it didn't really do too well, and personally GoFundMe should only be used for, like, the sick and charities. So I came out of my personal time and personal energy to help her out. And I didn't mind helping her out because she needed it. It's a real shame that adults expected a child to be able to afford something like this. Are you mental? I'm asking. Because fursuits can be an upwards of, even the cheapest ones are more than $500. How is a kid gonna come up with that again? Yeah. They're not. Anyway, Emma, I hope you like her. I know she's not perfect, but she's the cutest bean. Look at her. She's just, I love your character so much. Here's her little stripies on the back of her neck. The inside is lined. Not the best lining, but I'm working on that. Well, Emma, I'm gonna get this packed up and sent to you. And I hope you wear it to many, many cons, because I just wanted to see you be happy rather than bullied for no reason. You really didn't deserve that. I already know what a bunch of furs are gonna say. Oh, I was bullied too. Where's my free fursuit? Thing is, I only have so much time in the day. I have a full queue, and this story was the story that hit my heart. You're welcome to post your story, but I chose to do this. I chose to give her this gift. Also because I've gotten to know her mother personally. I know they're very nice people. Gifts are gifts because the person chose to give it out. Please don't ask me for free fursuits. I like making gifts, but I don't like being begged for them. So just be a nice person, and maybe I'll notice you. And please don't be my friend for a free fursuit. Please. I'm still a person. And I'm not gonna give one to every one of my friends. I just want you all to know that Emma's situation had a huge impact on my heart and the way I feel about the furry fandom as a whole. And I can't even imagine what it's doing to normies to see little kids get bullied over a suit. Like, you're making the entirety of the fandom look awful. Like we're so vain or something. Like, that's not the case at all. We should be happy. We should support each other, no matter the quality of the suit. And if you see someone's like this tall and they're wearing a maskimal, let them. They are a kid. Let me repeat, a child. Don't be an asshole. Well, that pretty much wraps up this video. I hope you like, and Emma, I hope you enjoy your suit. I'll be sending it out now.
You gonna put her on? You look so cute! Hold on. You got hands.
Yeah. Now here's the other one.
And you got a tail. You
and it here says, is a letter, a card. Let's see what it says.
Happy. Looks adorable.
Can you read it to her?
A bunch of her cards. And it says, Emma, I made this for you. Not only because you were so strong at BLFC 2018, but also because I feel in my heart that you deserve it. BLFC this year should be a lot cooler because you'll be able to wear your beloved persona. Don't listen to what mean mice say. Just turn and walk away. Those people are no good, so don't waste your breath talking to them. You are amazing for not giving up on the fandom. I made you this gift to show you what this fandom is truly about. Support and acceptance. I've chosen in my spare time to plan all of this out. And thank your mommy for me too. She helped pay for the fur. I couldn't have done it without her. Even though I could have sort of tried to save it for myself. She was a huge help. I support you being a furry, and so do all the people making you gift art. Opalite the Fox.
You are adorable, babe.
I'm taking a picture.
You want to say thank you?
Thank you.
case anybody's wondering, Emma took a total of about 6 months of work. I did her in-between commission, so it was rather slow, but her mom was happy to wait. I made it just in time for BLFC though. So I really hope she has a good time. I will see you next time. I saved a few and I keep them in a jar. I'd like to make myself believe that planet Earth turns slowly. It's hard to say that I'd rather stay awake when I'm asleep, 'cause everything is never as it seems.